Thank you all for being here today. C'est extrêmement important qu'on ait cette conversation, qu'on encourage les gens aussi fortement que possible de regarder la tarification du carbone comme un outil puissant pour transformer notre économie mondiale et atteindre le net zéro d'ici 2050. We've known for a long time that carbon pricing is one of the most powerful ways of reducing emissions and supporting and encouraging private sector and individual citizens to make smarter choices around reducing emissions at the same time as we create innovations to move forward. But it's hard. It's always been hard to do this in the way that we know citizens want more action on climate, but are always worried that they're going to be the ones paying for the brunt of it. And what a strong carbon price does when it's properly designed is actually drive those price signals to the private sector, transform the economy, and support citizens in encouraging them to make better choices. In Canada, we have a price on pollution that's going to rise to $170 a ton by 2030, which makes it among the strongest in the world, and at the same time, one of the most stringent in the world, covering about 75% of our emissions. Those are two metrics that we need to start looking at around the world, but the reality is there are many different ways of putting a price on pollution in different sectors. In Canada, we know from one province to the other, there have been different approaches. And what matters is to establish a principle of stringency and equity that makes sure that everyone is pricing at the same level. And that's why one of the things I think we all know needs to come out of COP is a clearer call to create a global standard around putting a price on pollution. Not only will that encourage innovation, give that clear price signal to the private sector that making the right capital investments to transform to lower emissions makes sense, but it also ensures that those who are leading on pricing pollution don't get unfairly penalized. We've had to bring in particular mechanisms to make sure that we're not unfairly penalizing particularly trade-exposed industries, but we'd love to not have to do that, and the more countries come on board with carbon pricing, the more we make sure that everyone around the world gets to do their part and push things in the right direction. The other piece of it, if we recognize right now that only about 20% of global emissions are covered by a price on pollution, we should be ambitious and say, as of right here today, that we want to triple that. 60% of global emissions should be covered by a price on pollution in 2030. Nous appelons à la planète entière, au gouvernement de la planète, de tripler la couverture d'un prix sur la pollution et de s'assurer que 60% des émissions à travers le monde soient captées par un système de tarification du carbone. C'est un idéal, un objectif ambitieux, mais c'est un objectif qu'on peut atteindre. We know it. Leaders know it, scientists know it, and the private sector knows it, that putting a price on pollution is the most efficient and powerful way to keep 1.5 alive. That's the call collectively we're making today, and I am so pleased that so many people have pledged themselves to be part of it. I would be remiss not to give a shout out to our Environment Minister, Stephen Guilbeault, who's here today. We have a number of partners from Environment Ministers from subnational governments. One of our premiers, Andrew Fury, is here. But I also want to recognize the hard work of our previous Environment Ministers, including Catherine McKenna and Jonathan Wilkinson, who's now our Minister of Natural Resources, who will deeply be involved in energy. Canada is committed to leading on this, and we're so glad there are so many others stepping up to be part of it. Merci beaucoup.